Welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Saliha Jamal from Department of Geography, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh. Today we are going to discuss about the module Extinction of Species with Special Reference to India, which comes under Environmental Geography. The learning objectives are to explain the types of extinction processes, next to recognize the causes of extinction, then to explain the status of extinction of species in India, and next to have clear understanding about the conservation and management of threatened species. Now let's start with introduction. A species becomes extinct when the last existing member of that species dies. Extinction therefore becomes a certainty when there are no surviving individuals that are able to reproduce and create a new generation. A species may become functionally extinct when only a handful of individuals survive, which are unable to reproduce due to poor health, age, sparse distribution of over a large range, a lack of individuals of both sexes in sexual reproducing species, or other reasons. Speciation, that is evolution of new species, and species extinction, that is complete elimination of species, are the natural processes which follow the evolution of animal. Just to illustrate the degree of biodiversity loss we are facing, let's take you through one scientific analysis that is given by Singh in 2010. The rapid loss of species we are seeing today is estimated by experts to be between 1000 and 10,000 times higher than the natural extinction rate. These experts calculate that between 0.01 and 0.1% of all species will become extinct each year. If the low estimate of the number of species out there is a true, that is that there are around 2 million different species on our planet, then that means between 200 and 2000 extinction occur every year. But if the upper estimate of a species number is true, that there are 100 million different species coexisting with us on our planet, then between 10,000 and 1 lakh species are becoming extinct each year, which was given by World Wildlife Fund in 2017. Now, we'll study about the types of extinction processes. Now, what is extinction process? Extinction is a natural process. Species have disappeared and new ones have evolved to take their place over the long geological history of the Earth. During the past 3.5 billion years, 4 billion species are estimated to have evolved, of which 99% have gone extinct. It is useful to distinguish three types of extinction processes, which are as follows. Natural extinction. As the environment condition changes with time, some species disappear and some are ready to take the place of disappeared ones, which are more adapted to the changed conditions. This loss of a species which occurred in the geological past at a very slow rate is called natural or background extinction. The second one is mass extinction. Mass extinction are periodic rises in the extinction rate above the background level. They are events which are not caused by changes in habitat or competition but catastrophes. There are the mass extinctions, they cause a dramatic decrease in the Earth's biodiversity and punctuate the Earth's history and are used by geologists to break the geological time. Recent thinking has, however, been to class events by their ecological impacts rather than by the number of species lost. Scientists have identified 5 main extinction events in Earth history, with some so severe that more than 90% of all life forms were killed off. These 5 extinction events are famous by the name of Big Five, which are as follows. The late Ordovician event, that is 438 million years ago, when 100 families went extinct. The next is late Devonian, that is 360 million years ago, when 30% of families went extinct. The third one is End Permian, that 245 million years ago, the biggest extinction of all time, when over 50 million of all families were lost. The fourth one is late Triassic, that is 35% of families died out. And the fifth one is the Cretaceous, the Tertiary, that is 65 million years ago. This ended the reign of dinosaurs. According to a report by the Guardian, after the Big Five, the modern world is experiencing a sixth great extinction of animal species, even when the lowest estimates of the extinction rates are considered. Scientists have warned. The rate of extinction for species in the 20th century was up to 100 times higher than it would have been without man's impact. Today we are in the middle of sixth extinction event that began about 50,000 years ago, but is now accelerating in an alarming speed. This extinction event is not a natural event, but is caused directly or indirectly by humans. Most recent extinctions have been associated with European expansions in the 15th and 16th century. Anthropogenic extinction, first one is, an increasing number of species in disappearing species from the face of the earth due to human activities. Each of the past mass extinction was spread over a million years or less compared to only 200 years of the anticipated extinction due to human interference. Thus, in comparison to mass extinction of geological past, the man-made mass extinction represents a very severe depletion of biodiversity. As many as 733 animals, mostly vertebrates and mollusks, and 110 plant species, that is flowering plants and lower groups of plants, and one red algae have been extinct or extinct in the wild since 1500 AD. The next extinction, that is the causes of extinction. When one talk about the extinction, then it becomes necessary to understand that it is not just about the disappearance of a single species, but also the effects of its disappearance to the environment that it interacts with. It's a broad topic. Concerned groups and governments are trying to save these endangered species through breeding and preserving their habitat, but these are all temporary solutions. What we need to do is to address the root cause of extinction of species. Extinction have happened several times in our geological history, and they were mostly caused by natural events such as comets and volcanic eruptions, and some causes remain unknown. Though there are several natural causes of species extinction, but the modern man has accelerated the pace of extinction. It is believed that about 200 species of mammals, birds have become extinct during the last 2000 years. During the contemporary time, the situation is that a few members of species of plants and animals have come down to such a small size that if they are not provided with immediate protection, they will soon become extinct. Some of the main causes of extinction are discussed now. The first one is overhunting, unregulated or illegal killing or poaching. Overhunting is one of the main cause of extinction by the human beings, because human beings kill animals for getting some precious things such as the ivory of elephants, the fur and organs of tigers, the deliciousness of tuna fish, and supposedly the medicinal effect of shark's fin are some of the examples that man has hunted these animals to the point of extinction. Illegal killings and poachings of rare plants and animals is a human cause of extinction, and unfortunately, across the world, various socio-economic factors drive hunting and poaching of endangered plant and animal species, and where this occur at unregulated, unsustainable levels, vulnerable species may be pushed towards extinction. The next reason is the destruction of habitat. Presently, it can be seen that one of the biggest cause of animal extinction, the main habitat where most of the animals live, is that forest, and the process of deforestation has killed off more species than we can count. The whole of the ecosystem lives in the forest, and it is believed that all our rainforest can disappear in the next 100 years. The process of deforestation will be left unchecked. Other anthropogenic factors are construction of highways, expressways, urban encroachment on agricultural land, artificial land drainage, etc. Some natural phenomena too become the cause of species extinctions, such as floods, volcanoes, hurricanes, etc. When a plant or animal does not have a habitat and cannot adapt to the different environment, it will become extinct. The next major cause is pollution. Apart from forests, the next main habitat of the animal and plant is the water, such as oceans, rivers, ponds, lakes. Man, because of unchecked industrial development, is introducing unnatural chemicals into the water bodies. These chemicals enter into the body of animals living in water and affecting their metabolic activities. Threats in marine and freshwater systems are poorly understood, but it appears that overexploitation is presently the greatest threat to marine species, followed by habitat loss, incidental death in fisheries, affects seabirds, marine mammals, and others. Man is also polluting the air, which is home of thousands of birds and animals. Air pollutants such as carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen oxides are very harmful for the animal and plant species. Now, next is the introduction to foreign species is also recognized as a major cause of extinction. The introduction of foreign or alien species in a new territory can often lead to ecological and economic disaster. An introduced species niche may overlap that of a native species. The newcomer may outcompete the native species, resulting in its extinction. Though species are often intentionally introduced to improve fishing and hunting, it can lead to problems also. Invasive alien species were historically the greatest threat to birds, followed by over-exploitation and habitat loss. Today, habitat loss has emerged as the dominant threats to bird, followed by invasive species and over-exploitation. The next is competition. Ongoing evolutionary processes are driven by competition, and over long periods of times, plants and animal taxa that are unable to adapt may be outcompeted and naturally displaced from their habitat and pushed towards extinction. Diseases are also the major cause. The sudden outbreak of diseases and pest infections caused by changed environmental conditions of the region concerned causes species extinction. Sometimes the sudden events are also the cause of extinction. Some sudden events like forest fires, volcanic eruptions, etc., causes species extinction. द नेक्स्ट इज नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल वाइल्ड लाइफ ट्रेड विच ऑल्सो इज अ ग्रेट कॉज फॉर द स्पीशीज एक्सटिंक्शन. पोचिंग एंड पोचिंग दैट इज लीगल एंड इनलीगल बोथ. वाइल्ड लाइफ ट्रेड्स आर अनदर कॉमन ट्रेड्स थ्रेट आर थ्रेट टू द एनिमल्स. सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ट्रेड आर पेट ट्रेड, फर ट्रेड, बुश मीट ट्रेड, बॉडी पार्ट्स ट्रेड एंड ट्रेड फॉर बायोमेडिकल रिसर्च. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्सटिंक्शन ऑफ स्पीशीज इन इंडिया. व्हेन वन लुक्स एट नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन ऑफ इंडिया इट लुक्स लश ग्रीन एंड अंडमान प्रिस्टाइन बट समवेयर डीप इन वाइल्डनेस ऑफ इंडियाज बायोडाइवर्सिटी हॉटस्पॉट एवरीथिंग इज नॉट फाइन because loss of habitat is on its way due to deforestation and human encroachment is silently pushing hundreds of trees and plant species to brink. The World Conservation Union, that is IUCN, has put 45 tree species across India on its Red List of Threatened Plant Species to in 2007 as being critically endangered. It has flagged 247 tree species from the country as threatened. The Ilex cassiana, a high altitude tree found only in Meghalaya, has run into its last generation. There are just 4 left in a small area, mostly confined to Shillong Peak, the list says. The IUCN's critically endangered list is for species facing an extremely high risk of extinction in the immediate future. It says trees like Ilex cassiana may vanish because of poor regeneration and habitat decline. About 247 species of plants faced grave threat and were being overused for medicinal and religious purposes without adequate conservation. In the Nilgiri Hills, there is a tree that goes by a name of Actinoda finalenta. The Red List says that there is just one of it left. In 2006, the Botanical Survey of India recollect an extremely rare species after a gap of 65 years from Arunachal Pradesh. One species in the northeast, that is Bongania, had become extinct when large scale felling took place to create space for tea gardens. There are no records for many species feared extinct since 2000. The next we are going to discuss about the extinct and endangered species of animals and birds in India. Extinction is an accepted phenomena, and anything created on this earth destined to come into extinction at some period of time, which is true in several cases discussed in detail in the latter part of this discussion. As we all know that we have come to the verge of sixth extinction event that has already began some 50,000 years ago, and now it is accelerating. India is among those countries which are encountering wildlife extinction day by day and from the last 90 years. And this rate is accelerating at a great pace. There was a time when India was home for some of the most beautiful wild animals. Due to excessive hunting and poaching for sport and body parts by man, these wild animals have become extinct. India has numerous varieties of wild species as their natural habitat due to tropical environment. Along with 17 mega diverse countries, India is home to about 60-70% of the world biodiversity. With European expansion, and urbanization, most of the extinction in India has been witnessed. Apart from the brutal human behaviors to fulfill their greed and their unauthorized hobbies, including shooting and hunting, have also led to the loss of the count of these species. India alone is the major cause of loss of number of species of the wild organisms, including the Bengal tiger, which is ironically our national animal. Some of the wild species are on the brink of extinction and some of them are already extinct, such as Indian cheetah, which is also known as Asiatic cheetah, has been known to exist in India for very long time ago due to excess of hunting, deforestation and habitat loss. The fastest land animal on earth become extinct in India. Today this species only survive in some parts of Iran. The government is planning to introduce this species in India with the help of international organizations. India aurochs. The Indian aurochs once lived in the hot and dry areas of India. The huge wild cattle were larger than most modern domestic cattle, with the height of 6.6 feet and weight of 1000 kg. Sivatram, that is also known as Shiva's beast. Sivatram was a very large, approximately 7 feet tall, extinct animal found in India. The giant beast was first discovered in India, where it was called Sivatram due to the Hindu god Lord Shiva. The Sivatram were the tallest and the fastest monsters found in India ever. The next is Sumatran rhinoceros. The Sumatran rhinoceros has been declared as one of the extinct animal in India. The Sumatran rhinoceros is the smallest rhinoceros with two horns and only extant species of the genus, that is Dicerones. The extinct Sumatran rhinoceros once roamed and inhabited rainforest of India and neighbor Northeast Asian countries. They are now critically endangered species and estimated to number fewer than 275 only and found in neighboring countries of India. The next is endangered leopard, that is also known as Panthera juncale. It is one of the most secretive cats, and not many people in the world have had the privilege to see them in the wild in India. The wild cat loves to roam in the rocky mountain ranges of high altitude and is estimated that in India there are about 200 to 600 snow leopards found in Hemis National Park, in East Ladakh, Nanda Devi National Park and Valley of Flowers National Park in the states of Uttarakhand, a UNESCO Natural World Heritage Site, and Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary near Anil. Pink-headed duck, the species that is on brink. Pink-headed duck was a large driving blackish-brown duck. It was one of the most beautiful bird in India. The long-necked duck once found in throughout India, but its beautiful appearance made it most hunted bird in India. Due to excess of hunting, this beautiful bird is fall in the category of extinct birds in India. This bird was also found in Bangladesh and northern Myanmar. They become extinct during 1960s. The next in this category is Siachus parakeet. Siachus parakeet is a bird similar in appearance to a parrot, used to be found in the Indian Ocean islands of the Seychelles group. Main reason for their extinction was intense persecution by farmers and coconut plantation owners. The species was extinct by 1906. The next in this species is Aquilae riemannicensis. that is an economically important tree species known for its precious resin impregnated with agar wood, variously known as eagle wood, aloes wood and garu. This tree is a rich and a sacred source of oleoresin since ancient period of time. It has been utilized in Egypt, Arabia and throughout Far East from time immemorial, incense, perfume, medicinal, writing material, ceremonial uses, etc. Assam region of Northeast India is believed to be the origin of agar wood and spread throughout Southeast Asia. Because of its multifarious uses of high market demand, mature agar wood trees have been harvested indiscriminately from wild, resulting in rapid decline of the species in natural habitat. The next addition is Gladiosa samica and Gymnocladusa samica. These two are the endemic tree species of Northeast India. Both the sister genera have typical distribution pattern and a few species are available in North and South America, Egypt and Vietnam. Clear felling along with habitat degradation severely affected the natural population of these trees, and these species is also listed as vulnerable in the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species in 2009. The next in this species is, that is, G. assamicus, locally known as Minangma. That is, it can be called as Minangmangbashi by the Mompa tribe in a medium size, that is 15 to 17 meter in height, deciduous tree. Highly saponaceous mature pods are popularly used in cleansing and religious activities. Natural population of this variety is extremely small, having very few reproducing individuals. Though the species is not included in IUCN Red List of the threatened species, but it has been designated as critically endangered regionally and also included in priority list for National Recovery Program in India. The next, it comes, can extinction be stopped? This is a great question which arises. The threats which has been discussed in the present discussion above is threatening our wildlife, whether it is to animal or plant, is increasing and will continue to rage out of control until we have eventually nothing left remaining within the wild. Though extinction of any species, whether plant or animal, takes much time to extinct, but once they are gone forever. Thus, those species that are under threatened category requires a combination of conservation and response to save them. From the mega fauna to plants and reptiles to birds, everything living and breeding is in dire need of protection. Human overpopulation will most certainly be the biggest threat to wildlife. Overpopulation is not going to decrease anytime soon, and sadly, planet Earth does not grow any larger. Something eventually has to give. There is no easy answer to stem the vast wildlife hemorrhaging, but one cannot simply wait and watch these wildlife species dying and getting extinct. Something has to be done in order to save them, because they are assets, and once loosened, they will never return back. If proper steps had taken in the past, so the species of plants and animals that has been extinct might have been present amongst us today. These responses with respect to the conservation and management of species extinction includes research, स्पीशीज स्पेसिफिक एक्शंस, साइट्स एंड हैबिटेट बेस्ड इंटरवेंशंस, पॉलिसी रिस्पॉन्सेज एंड कम्युनिकेशन एंड एजुकेशन. द टूल्स एंड टेक्निक्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर स्टॉपिंग द एक्सटिंक्शन आर इफेक्टिव मैनेजमेंट एंड रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ हैबिटेट्स एंड इकोसिस्टम दैट आर डिस्ट्रॉयड बाई नेचुरल फिनोमिना एंड द ह्यूमन बींग्स. Judicious use of pesticides, herbicides and other chemical inputs which are greatly used in agriculture can be helpful to reduce extinction of species. The conservation and management requires capital, thus creation of incentives and finance for conservation is necessary. Hope student, you all must have understood about the importance of extinction of species and what is the status of species extinction in India. That's all here to explain. Thank you.